के इसी हॉल में ये शब्द अनेकों बार गूंजा है, वसुधैव कुटुंबकम। हम पूरे विश्व को एक परिवार मानते हैं। ये हमारी संस्कृति, संस्कार और सोच का हिस्सा है। संयुक्त राष्ट्र में भी भारत ने हमेशा विश्व कल्याण को ही प्राथमिकता दी।
Dear friends and viewers, today we shall discuss about the speech delivered by the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi ji, at the United Nations General Assembly 2020 virtual session. He has rightly pointed out that India is proud of the fact that it is one of the founding members of the United Nations General Assembly in the year 1945. It's also a fact that India has made a lot of contributions in the establishment of the International Labour Organization in the year 1920. Quite naturally, as Indians, as a nation, we should take credit in the establishment of the United Nations General Assembly and also the International Labour Organization. We have made a lot of contributions to the International Committee of Nations. And one of the finest speech is this: India is the largest democracy of the world. He has rightly pointed out that 18% of the world population consists of India. That means, in India, though it has diversities in languages, diversities in religions, diversities in cultural identities and other ways, and even political ideologies of different nations, India is united together. I have contributed to the international community as a whole for the centuries together. It was the brilliant speech made by our Honorable Prime Minister of India. We are not going to dispute all these facts. And he has further mentioned about the Vasudevaga Kudumbakam. Vasudevaga Kudumbakam means the whole world is a family, and he has rightly pointed out that the words of Vasudevaga Kudumbakam, the whole world is a family, are often reverberated in the all of the United Nations. We treat the whole world one family. It is a part of our culture, character and thinking. The best thing is that the Vasudevaga Kudumbakam, he used to tell these things in the international forum, highlighting the highness of the Indian civil society and its civilization to the Committee of Nations and to the international community for its richness and greatness. The point is that the Vasudevaga Kudumbam concept, that is, the whole world is one family, should be reverberated in Indian context. That is our point. India is a country of many religions, many languages, many cultures, and full of diversities. All these diversities should be appreciated, and all the controversies arising out of this caste, creed and other things should be wiped out from the top of the political executive. If such ugly things or discriminations have been taking place in the soil of India, it is the onus of the central government or state government to come to the rescue of the victims, not protecting the perpetrator as it is happening in Athras and other parts of the country. And another thing is that India has always thought about the interest of the whole world and mankind, and not about its Western interest. This philosophy has been drawing the forces of India's policies. This is one of the version given by the Honorable Prime Minister of India. We also welcome it because we should make our contribution to the humankind, human race, and for its betterment and progress in all possible ways. Finally, he talked about the peace, security, and prosperity of the international community. India will not hesitate to raise its voice against the enemies of humanity, human race, and human values, and so many other things. We are not having our neighborhood relationship with Pakistan, China, Nepal, and other countries. My point is that whatever the speech of the Prime Minister Narendra Modi is good and welcomeable in the international forum, but the same principles and concepts should be applied in the Indian context. He has talked a lot about the cultural heritage of the country, but in the year 1992, the Babri Masjid was demolished. The point is that cultural heritage of India should be protected as per the statement given by the Prime Minister of India. This is my humble appeal to the Prime Minister of India. What a lot of the speeches he has delivered in the international forum should be applied in Indian context in all earnest. Thank you so much.